Hello everyone and welcome to NewsClick. I'm Apoorva.
And I'm Prashant. And here are the top stories for the day.
We begin with an interview with Bilkis Bano, whose case we have been following very closely over the past week. Just 2 days ago, the Supreme Court ordered Gujarat government to pay 50 lakh rupees to Bilkis as compensation. She had suffered horrific violence during the 2002 Gujarat riots. In this exclusive interview, Bilkis talks to NewsClick about what she went through when she first went to the Gujarat police to file an FIR, and how this order actually, what it means to others fighting for justice.
जब मैं जो हादसा गुजरा वहाँ से उस वक्त पुलिस का व्यवहार कुछ अच्छा नहीं था और मैं पुलिस स्टेशन पहुँची उसके बाद दूसरे दिन मैंने FIR दर्ज कराई वो लोग मुझे धमकी दे रहे थे पुलिस उन्होंने बोला कि अभी तू सब बोलेगी सबका नाम ले रही है और सबका बता रही है सब तेरे को जहर का इंजेक्शन दे के मार डालेंगे जो मैंने बोला कि अब पढ़ के सुनाओ मेरे को जो मैंने वो दिया बयान दिया है वो पढ़ के सुनाओ तो उन्होंने मेरे को धमकी दी और ज़बरदस्ती अंगूठा लेके मेरा लगा दिया
जितने टाइम ये केस चला गुजरात में और उसके बाद भी जब थोड़े टाइम तक गुजरात की ही सरकार और गुजरात की ही पुलिस इस पे तफ्तीश कर रही थी तो उन्होंने किस तरीके से आपके केस को कमज़ोर करने की कोशिश की अगर आप थोड़ा सा बता सकें तो कुछ आप बोलती हों वो नहीं सुनते हों या गलत कुछ चीज़ें दर्ज करते हों या ऐसा कुछ अगर हुआ हो आपके साथ आपको क्यों लगा कि मैं गुजरात में मुझे न्याय नहीं मिलेगा
उनको पहले से हमारे साथ ऐसा व्यवहार किया तो फिर हमको तो लगेगा ना कि हमको न्याय नहीं मिलेगा इधर और 1.5 साल तक बन रहा हमारा केस कुछ सुनवाई नहीं हुई हमारी
तो अभी अब आपको इस फैसले के बाद कैसा लग रहा है आपको क्या लगता है कि आगे आप क्या करना चाहोगे
अब आगे हम जो सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने आदेश दिया है बहुत सारा दिया है बहुत अच्छा दिया है हमारे लिए और भी महिलाए हैं उनको भी अल्लाह दिलाए हमारे जैसा जो अल्लाह दिया हमको उनको भी मिलना चाहिए और उनको भी इंसाफ चाहिए
यू कैन विजिट आवर वेबसाइट टू वॉच द फुल इंटरव्यू सो ऑन टू आवर नेक्स्ट स्टोरी वी टेक यू टू द 4 विलेजेस इन बनारस दैट वर अडॉप्टेड बाय प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी अंडर द आदर्श गांव योजना Our team spoke to the residents of these villages to try and find out if any development had taken place in the last 5 years. This is what they had to say.
Jayapur, Manipur, Lachulapur, Musepur. Okay, Musepur jo aaye the, Musepur, Nasana, Biaspur. Okay, itna gaon mein duhate hain, sab pareshan hain. Aisa koi nahi ki nahi pareshan hai.
Vote lena hai to le lijiye, leke aka ba ba ba. Akal pehchane ge nahi.
लोग हताश हैं परेशान हैं लोगों को समझ में नहीं आ रहा है कि सड़क से विकास हम समझें ये जो बड़ी अच्छी अच्छी लाइटें लगी हैं शहर में उसको उससे हम विकास अपना समझें कि हमारे घर में 2 वक्त की रोटी नहीं है उसको हम विकास के रूप में देखें
इतना पैसा नहीं आ रहा है घर बनाने के लिए अभी जितनी मार फेंका देते सभी लोग दिन दिन का लाकर रखते हैं घर बनवाने के लिए
India will host the FIFA Under-17 Women's World Cup in 2020. It will be the first time a women's team from the country will participate in any of the FIFA's World Cups. But even today, football is far from a mass sport as far as women's participation is concerned. Sports journalists Mihir Vasavda and Sharda Ugra were in our studio discussing the struggles of women who want to play sports in India.
I mean, as we are talking, there are the junior national championships happening, right? They're taking place in Kolhapur, which at this point, it is around 40, 42 degrees over there. They gave all the states time of 15 days to register their players. Now, the problem here is that none of the states have an active youth program. I was speaking to the president of Andhra Pradesh Football Federation, who's also, I think, in the AFF's finance committee. He was very careful in the words he chose to speak. And his point was, ki yaar, हमारे पास अगर जो 10 लड़कियां ऑन अ गुड डे अभी आ जाती है तो हम खुश हो जाते हैं. हम 30 प्लेयर्स कहाँ से इकट्ठे करेंगे? फ्रॉम वेयर डू वी गेट 30 प्लेयर्स टू सेंड अ टीम फॉर द जूनियर नेशनल चैंपियनशिप्स? इट वॉज द सेम प्रॉब्लम इन मोस्ट स्टेट्स आई स्पोक टू. सिक्किम डिड नॉट सेंड अ टीम बिकॉज अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर फेडरेशन हु इज ऑल्सो इन द AFF एग्जीक्यूटिव कमिटी आई थिंक ही सेड दैट तभी वहाँ पर इलेक्शंस थे एंड अगर जो टीम चली जाती उनकी तो उनके पेरेंट्स उनके कोच कोई वोट नहीं कर पाता. सो दे कम्प्लीटली गेव द टूर्नामेंट अ मिस. You have Mizoram who didn't have enough time to prepare a team for this. My point is you're going to choose your first batch of under 17 World Cup team from here and you don't even know if your best players are going there. Delhi, for example, the biggest problem was the exams were clashing with the tournament, with the selection trials. So half of the girls did not turn up. School exams. Yeah. So if you knew a little while ago that you're going to have the under 17 World Cup, I'm sure AIFF did not come to know with the FIFA press release.
No, of course.
So
you never know.
you never know. But I'm guessing they knew a couple of months in advance. They sent out a release to all the state associations about the junior national championships a week after FIFA made this announcement. And then they give them 15 days to select 30 players each. एंड बाद में और 15 दिन में आपको आपकी ट्रेन टिकट्स रिजर्व करके कोल्हापुर पहुंचना है जहां पर 45 डिग्रीज में आप आपके चैंपियनशिप्स करा रहे हो. सो इट इज वेरी बिजार ऑल ऑफ दिस.
द फुल डिस्कशन विल बी आउट ऑन द लेटेस्ट एपिसोड ऑफ आवर इंडियन फुटबॉल शो 420 ग्राम्स. नाउ वी आर जॉइंड बाय प्रशांत टू टेक अस थ्रू आवर इंटरनेशनल स्टोरीज ऑफ द डे.
आवर फर्स्ट स्टोरी इज फ्रॉम साउथ अफ्रीका वेयर वर्कर्स ऑफ एन ArcelorMittal प्लांट प्रोटेस्टेड यस्टरडे इन फ्रंट ऑफ द इंडियन हाई कमीशन इन प्रिटोरिया. द वर्कर्स who were organized by the National Metal Union Workers of South Africa, said that the company was engaging in unfair labor practices. Over 1,000 employees have been affected. The workers insisted that ArcelorMittal, which is owned by Lakshmi Narayan Mittal, an Indian billionaire, give them justice. Last year, a constitutional court in South Africa had ruled that any worker who earns less than 205,000 rands a year, which is around $14,000, and is hired by a labor broker, should be made into a permanent employee after 3 months of work. However, ArcelorMittal has tried to evade this rule by claiming that the 1,000 employees in their plant were hired not by a labor broker but by a service provider. NUMSA has pointed out that the use of the term service provider is just an excuse as far as the company is concerned. As a result of this so-called excuse, what happens is that many of these employees do not get proper salaries and other benefits. For instance, these employees get only around 2,600 rands a month, which is even less than the minimum wage of 3,500 rands. This has been actually called by as a slave law. Due to all these reasons, the workers began protesting in March. A few days after the protest began, some of the workers were arrested by the police and were later released after NUMSA intervened. The protesters in front of the Indian High Commission yesterday said that India, as a founding member of the International Labour Organization, should ensure that its citizens do not exploit workers, especially those from those in other countries. Here is a look at some footage from the protest yesterday. Our second story is from Russia, where North Korean leader Kim Jong-un and Russian President Vladimir Putin met in the city of Vladivostok. This summit acquires great significance as it happens after the failed Hanoi summit between US President Donald Trump and Kim Jong-un. After the meeting, Putin said that North Korea needed some guarantees if it wanted to continue with its denuclearization process. This matches closely with North Korea's own position, which is that denuclearization can happen only if the US withdraws its sanctions. On the other hand, the Trump administration has been insisting that denuclearization should happen first and everything else comes later. Putin also focused on the fact that the process has to be a multilateral one involving many countries, and he has indicated that this might help in providing some of the guarantees that North Korea requires. It is still unclear what the results of this meeting will be and how this will affect the North Korea-US process. That's all we have time for today. To follow these stories, check out our website newsclick.in and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.